Today, we are considering the point mobility and radio resource management in IS 95. Myself, Dr. Rajendra Dubey, Professor, Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering Department. At the end of this session, the student will be able to learn the concept of mobility and radio resource management in IS 95. The IS 95 standard is most complex because of the use of split spectrum that brings with the set of advantage which is not available to the time division multiple access based system. So that includes the frequency reuse factor of one of the robust performance in the presence of interference and multipath and ability to increase the capacity. So presence of interference, it may be in the any form, in the noise or anything. The multipath spreading includes the spreading the signal which is not receiving at the receiver with the good strength, and ability to increase the capacity. The capacity again gives the strength at the receiver of the signal that has been used for different standards. Now, operation with rake receiver is again very important in case of the CDMA channel. Now, it provides the inherent diversity in the presence of multipath fading to improve the voice quality. The ability is employed in the IS-95 is to perform what are known as soft handoffs, which improves the voice quality during the handoff, and also it provides the mobility management outside the soft handoff, which is based on the general mobility management. So in case of CDMA, it specifies the messages which are additionally included. Using split spectrum technique, this having some disadvantage in the near-far effect becomes predominant, and in order to prevent the signal from one user over that of another user, strict power control has to be implemented. It increases the battery life and reduces the size and weight of the mobile terminal if it is implementing with the strict power control in the MS that can operate with the minimum requirement of E by N1 for academic performance. The soft handoff, it refers to the process when the MS is making the communication to the multiple base stations before finally deciding which to communicate its traffic to one of them. The reason of implementing the soft handoff again is the basis for in the near-far problem, and it is associated with power control mechanism. Now, since MSS moves far away from base station and it continues to increase its transmit the power to compensate for the near-far problem, it will vary like in an unstable situation. Also cause a lot of interference to MS with the neighboring cell. To avoid the situation and to ensure the strict communication with MS is communicated with the BS with the largest RSS, and MS will continuously track all the BSs nearby and then communicate with multiple BS for a short while if necessary before deciding which BS to select as its point of attachment. In IS-95 standards, three types of soft handoffs are defined, indicated. In the softer handoff cases, handoff includes two sectors from the same cell and a third sector from a different cell. In all the cases, the handoff decision mechanism is more or less the same. Whether the connection in the infrastructure needs to be down and set up again depends on the sectors involved in the final handoff. The soft handoff procedure involves several base stations. Controlling primary BS coordinates all this addition and deletion of other base station to the call during soft handoff. So as per the requirement, the controlling BS making the addition or deletion to avoid the problem of soft handoff. The primary BS uses handoff direction message to indicate the pilot channel to be used or removed as a part of soft handoff process. At some time, some of point of time, the primary BS is also changed after handoff. The signals from multiple BS are combined in the BSC or MSCs and processes in a single cell. This process is achieved by using a frame selector join message. The MS detects a pilot signal from new base station and informs the primary BS. The pilot signal from the old base station starts falling and the MS will request its removal, which is achieved via a frame selector remove message. The pilot channels of each cell are involved in the handoff mechanism. So in the first figure we can see it is a softer handoff, that is there is no any discommunication, there is a soft communication or a simple procedure. The MS is moving from one cell to the other cell and making the communication. In second case, again it is a soft handoff, no problem of, but in the third case it is softer handoff procedure has been shown. The MS maintains a list of pilot channels that it can be here and classifies them under in the four categories. The active set consists of pilots that are being continuously monitored or used by the MS. The MS has three rake fingers are in AIS 95 that allows it to monitor or use up to three pilots, and the active set pilot channels are indicated. In the setup and ending of the soft handoff, the MS is making the communication with the old BS that will give the pilot strength measurement. Then it will send the direction, handoff direction, making the acknowledgement, and the handoff direction message again received by the old MS. So this will make the completion of the handoff procedure. And lastly, the pilot measurement request has been sent by the old BS to the MS. Now, if you want to connect to the new BS, again the procedure handoff request has been allocated, then the acknowledgement has been sent, then some information related with the handoff has been again provided. So there is a master transfer, and that will make the acknowledgement from new BS to the new BS and from the old BS. And once it is completing the acknowledgement, we can have the pilot strength measurement. And once all the procedure has been completed, then we are ending with the soft handoff mechanism. So once it is a setup, one it is a ending has been included in that procedure from MS to the old BS to the new BS, and it is, which is again under the control of BSC and MSC. So again the frame selector join and acknowledgement and master transfer acknowledgement has been carried out under the control of BSC and MSC, and the frame selector remove again associated, that will make the smooth conduction of the soft handoff procedure. So this is a complete setup and ending of soft handoff procedure. In the SGM on the downlink by the BS, the candidate set can have at at most 6 pilots. These refer to the pilots that are not in the active set but that have a different RSS to be demodulated and used to demodulating the associated traffic channel. The remaining set contains all other possible pilots in the system. The receiver uses the rake to capture the multipath components. It employs the search windows to track each of the sets of pilot channel. The search windows are large enough to capture all the multipath components of the pilot from BS, but small enough to minimize searching time. The multipath delays are a function of distance between the MS and the BS, and the search windows are also affected. Several thresholds are used in the soft hand procedure. Whenever the strength in the pilot falls below a threshold, the MS starts the adverse timer. Unless the pilot strength goes back above the threshold before the timer expires, the MS will drop it from a given set. Trade-off between selection of high values and low values of these thresholds and timers. So we can make the selection in between the thresholds to select that adverse timer, whether to go for threshold level when the MS will drop it from the given set. Thank you.